Have you heard about the new machinery directive? We will tell you what's going to change and which safety requirements machine builders have to meet in the future. A few days ago, while I was looking through my wallet, I found my driver's license and it made me think, if I still had the same knowledge from way back then, we're talking a few years here, would I still be able to pass the current driver's test? Bearing in mind that in October 2022, over 50 new questions were added to Germany's theoretical driver's test, that's quite a lot. What I'm illustrating here is that rules and regulations change all the time. Something regarded as perfectly safe now might not be considered safe in the future. And this certainly applies to machine safety too. You may have heard that the European Union is going to release a new machinery directive to replace the old one from 2006. And if you think about the technological development we have seen since 2006, it makes a lot of sense to amend critical document too, especially those regulating machine safety in the European Union. To put this in perspective, 2006 was 1 year before the first iPhone was released. Let me tell you a little bit more about the machinery directive. It builds the foundation for machine safety in the European Union and is passed by the EU itself. But more importantly, it is part of product safety legislations within every single EU member country. Every machine builder is required by law to meet the requirements of the machinery directive before they can sell their machines in the European Union. To show that a machine is compliant with these requirements, the machine builder must put a CE mark on the machine. This shows customers and operators that a proper risk assessment has been undertaken and all potential hazards have been reduced to an acceptable level. To get a deeper understanding of the topic, I would like you to meet Daniel. He's one of our safety experts here at HMS. Daniel has a lot of experience dealing with the current machinery directive and has had a look at the coming version to see what will change. Daniel, it's nice to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, hey.
Hey.
Imagine I'm an AGV manufacturer. What will change for me once the new machinery directive comes into effect?
Well, yeah, there are numerous changes with the new machinery directive that's coming. First of all, let's start with a positive note. You will no longer be required to send a full paper version of your documentation with your machine. It's sufficient to send a digital version. This not only saves a lot of paper and therefore also helps the environment, it also helps the customer because in a digital version you can do cross-reference, you can do better upgrades without exchanging paper and printing a lot. So that helps the manufacturers a lot. That's one positive side for the new machinery directive that's coming. Yeah.
Okay. I also heard that the autonomous mobile machinery will, for the first time, be explicitly mentioned in the directive. Is this true?
That's correct, yes. The rapid growth in this mobile machinery market, like automated guided vehicles or AGVs or autonomous mobile robots or AMRs, has led to a situation where the current legislation does not really keep up with the rapid growth of this market, so we have to amend this a little bit. There are some hazards for those mobile machines that weren't there before, like when the machine is wireless or when it's driving around, you need certain functions that you didn't need before, like a supervisory control function to help you from a remote point stop and start this machine. Yeah, that's a crucial function. It helps to remotely stop and start the machine if there are some problems with it, to just give you that safe feature to just from the outside stop the machine. You could basically call it a kill switch.
Okay. Could you give me a specific example to get a better understanding of the changes and problems that manufacturers might be facing?
Yeah, sure. Let's just take this so-called kill switch. You could do this, for example, with a safe remote emergency stop function. The emergency stop function itself is nothing new, so it has been part of EU legislations for decades now, and every machine basically needs this emergency stop function. But now we have the problem that the machines are no longer, as I said, wired. So you have to find a way to wirelessly cross this emergency stop signal. Let's visualize this with maybe an example where this would come handy. You have a fleet of robots that's operating in a confined zone where you have fences around it, some doors where you can have maintenance access. But the most important thing is that people are prohibited during regular production to enter this zone. So it's impossible for any human-machine interaction. With a situation like this, it's a good thing to think about what exact safety features you need on the robot itself. So if it's impossible for people to go in there, you don't really need to detect them. So you can basically do some cuts on the personal detection, and personal detection and sensor technology, for example, is really, really expensive. So the manufacturers, the integrators, the end customers, they could save a lot of money just because they say, we put a fence around it. They cannot drive over any people. But on the other side, that means if you, for some reason, have to enter the zone where the robots are, you have to definitely make sure that all the hazardous movement inside there is stopped. So that's where you need this remote stop function to tell every robot, now someone is in here, you cannot drive because you cannot detect them. So that means you now have to transfer the signal. The basic requirement, the emergency stop function, is the same requirement as if it was wired, but now it's wireless. So how could we do that? One possibility is through the safe field bus protocols, like ProfiSafe, like SIP safety. They give us the possibility to transfer this signal, this safe signal, over the existing wireless communication that the robot already has. So you can transfer the signal onto the robot itself to trigger this safe stop function. And to include this in a robot, it's pretty easy. You could, for example, use our Ixxat T100 Safe I/O module, combine that with the Anybus Compact Com module, and do the communication of this safe field bus signal to the outside and trigger this safe stop in the robot.
Wow, that's very interesting. Thanks for the insight. And I guess we will talk to you soon once the directive has passed.
Yes, most definitely. We will keep a close eye on the developments coming from this new machinery directive and also the new standards that will come from it. So I guess we will talk sometime in the near future again about this topic.
Okay, thank you, Daniel.
Thanks for having me.
So as you can see, there's going to be some interesting challenges ahead for manufacturers, for AGVs and AMRs. But here at HMS, we're keeping our fingers on the pulse and we'll keep you updated with more information and solutions to address the upcoming challenges. We'll make sure that you will have no issues getting an EU driver's license for your mobile machines, even with the new regulations in place. If you want to stay informed, please like and subscribe, get notifications and access over the next weeks and month to our upcoming videos covering machine safety. Until next time, thanks for watching, goodbye and take care.